Today I'm going to show you my top 5 WordPress block editor time-saving tips and tricks. The list view is one of the most useful aspects when you're working in the block editor. You can access it via this little icon up here, and it shows you a hierarchy of all the blocks on the page. But did you know you can open this by default without having to click this button every time you create a new page? All you need to do is come across to the top right, click on those three little icons there, come down to the bottom, click on preferences, and then turn on this little option here that says always open list view. Here's a few cool things you can do with the list view. Firstly, you can use it to navigate to the sections within your pages you want to edit. So you just click on it in the list view and it'll take you straight there, and then you can jump in here and make your edits. Secondly, the list view is drag and drop. So if you want to move sections around, you can do it all using the list view. So I'm going to grab this FAQ section, drag it to the top of my page, and there we go. You can also rename sections using the list view as well. So if I want to rename this group block here, I click on the three dots, come down here to rename, click on that, and then just pop in my new name here. The block editor also comes with some incredibly helpful keyboard shortcuts. Here's three of my favorite ones. The first one is you simply type /, and then the name of the block that you want to add. So in this case, column, and you don't even have to type the whole name. You can see it's found it, and I just hit return, and then it lets me add that block. Here's another one of my favorites. This lets you duplicate blocks just using a keyboard shortcut. Hold the up arrow, command on a Mac, and then just hit the D, and that will duplicate all your blocks. And if you want to invoke the command palette, just hit command K, and up she pops, and then you can type in any commands here to do cool stuff, like open list view. And there we go. If you want to see all the cool keyboard shortcuts that are available for you, click on the three dots in the top right of your screen, come down here to tools and click on keyboard shortcuts, and there's your reference. The block toolbar has some really neat tricks up its sleeve to help you save a bunch of time. First up, it lets you transform blocks into different types of blocks. I've selected the heading block here, and if I look at this little icon here and click on it, you can see I can transform that into a paragraph, a list, or a quote block in a single click. One of the biggest time savers is the ability to copy styles between blocks. I've selected this entire group block, click on the three dots and go copy styles. Then select this group block, click on the three dots and click paste styles, and the styles are pasted between blocks. As you start to build more complex layouts with the block editor, then one of the most useful shortcuts you're going to find on the toolbar is this option here. So you can be working within a block, and this lets you select the parent block that you're within. You just click on that, and then you can see it's actually selected the top level parent group block. The command palette will save you a bunch of time both navigating around your site and also taking action. For example, I can be editing the single post template in the site editor. If I want to actually go and look at a post that's using that template, I can use the command palette, just command K, and then I can type in the name of my post here, and it'll list it for me to go and access it. Here's a few other cool commands you can do with the command palette. You can add new posts, so just add new, and you can see you can add a new post or a page directly from here. Or if you wanted to go and edit the single post template from here, you can do that. Just type in single post template and it'll find it here. Click on that. It'll take you into the site editor so you can edit that. There's also a command to open the code editor. Just simply type code editor and it'll open up the code editor. And there's a command to close it as well. There's even a command to open the list view. But by far the biggest time saver you're going to find is if you start using patterns. Patterns are pre-designed layouts of blocks. And you can find patterns in three main places. The first place is within your theme. So I'm using the 2024 theme on this website, and you see if I click on patterns here, it comes with a whole bunch of layouts that I can use on my sites with a single click. For example, if I click on call to action here, here are all the layouts that the theme gives me that I can add into my pages. So if I like this one down here, I can click on it, and there it is within my page. And because it's just been built using WordPress blocks, I can edit everything. The other place you can find patterns is on WordPress.com. I will put a link in the description below, but you can access all these beautifully designed wireframes that you can just copy here and then paste right onto your website. WordPress.org also has its own pattern library where you can navigate and look at designs. And if you like any of them, you can click on them, and exactly the same idea, you can then copy it and then just paste that pattern into your site. So those are my personal top 5 time-saving tips and tricks when you're working in WordPress. But what are yours? Let me know by posting a comment below. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you found that interesting and useful. If you did, if you can hit the like button down below, it would be fantastic because it helps spread the word around the video around the internet and also on YouTube. And if you want to see more videos as part of this series that I'm filming for WordPress.com, hit that subscribe button and you'll be notified when we release new ones. Thanks for watching. Keep well, and I'll see you soon. Bye for now.